Right now, I'm going to show you four different ways to blur the background of a photograph. We're going to go from beginner, we're going to do intermediate, all the way through to pro. So you can choose the technique that you want based on the amount of time you want to put aside versus the result you're going to get. And by the way, I'm going to give you a link to the same image that I'm using. It's a free image from Adobe Stock. All right, let's jump in and get started. So I'm going to show you four different levels of blurring the background, starting from beginner all the way through to pros. So you can choose how much time you're willing to invest to get the result that you want. So let's start with the most basic version of blurring the background. This is probably the first time you ever used Photoshop. So we're going to select the subject. So we're just going to go here and we're going to use object selection tool because we want to select the woman. So under select subject, make sure you go and choose cloud. It's going to give you a better result. And then we're going to choose select subject. The next thing we need to do is inverse the selection. So we're going to choose select, inverse. So now the woman is not selected, just the background. And at this point, don't cringe if you're a pro. We're going to choose filter, blur. We're going to grab the Gaussian blur and we're going to click OK and turn off the selection. Okay, there's some obvious problems with this. The first one is the ground is just kind of blurred all around her. But the other one, and this is interesting because Photoshop actually does this in the quick actions and in the actions too, which is kind of sad. If you look around the edge, we've got all these halos. So if you're looking for a quick blur and maybe you can just crop off the bottom and maybe get away with that, fine. All right, so let's go into level two, which is going to be the intermediate level, which I believe is the first level that's actually going to be usable. So what we want to do now is we're going to choose select subject, just like we did before. So we've selected our model. This time we're going to pop her onto a new layer. So we're going to use Control J, and that will copy her. If I hide the background, you can see there she is on her own layer. But I'm going to hide the model right now and we're just going to show the background. So in order to load that selection, hold down the Control or the Command key and hover over that top layer. So even though it's hidden, we can still use it to make a selection. So holding down Control or Command, click, loads the selection. Remember, we're working on the background layer. The top layer is hidden, we just used the selection. All right, so we've got the selection. Let's just expand it a little bit. So let's choose Select. And then we're going to go down to modify where we can modify the selection. And then we're going to choose to expand it. And we don't have to do it much. Let's do it by 3 pixels. Click OK. So what this is doing is expanding it so those edges are not going to show. Now we want to fill this. So we could choose Edit Fill. And this will bring up the Fill dialog box. By the way, Shift Delete on Mac or Shift Backspace on Windows will also bring this up. And you want to choose Content Aware. And then click OK. And I'll turn off Control Command D, will turn off the selection. And it doesn't matter that it's kind of soft there, looking a little bit like a ghost. The important thing is what we're doing is we're getting rid of those edges so they're not going to bleed and give us those fuzzy edges that we had before. Okay, let's turn on the layer for our model. Notice I'm still on the background layer because we're going to be blurring the background, but we don't want to blur the model. All right, so now we're not just going to apply blur, because remember before we had the problem with the ground blurring as well, it looked very unrealistic. So what we're going to do is we're going to choose filter, and instead of choosing blur, we're going to go down one more to blur gallery, and then we're going to use the field blur. Notice when field blur opens up, we get this little ring, and this adjusts the amount of blur. And notice as I blur it, we're getting kind of what we got before, but notice we have the nice edges. We don't have those fuzzy edges anymore because of that content aware fill behind her. But notice the ground is still blurred like she's kind of a ghost floating. So what we want to do is add a second point. To do that, just tap. And notice now that we've got a second point. So we can adjust the amount of blur on both of these points so we can blend that blur. Now, I want to set this to 0. So I can just go in this wheel and I can move it down. Or here's a trick, hit the Control or Command key, hold that down, double click, and that will set it to 0. Notice now that the background is sharp near the bottom of the model, so this looks more realistic. Now we can adjust this fall off by moving these pins closer. Notice we bring these close, these pins closer together, it falls off very, very quickly. And if I pull them further apart, it will blend more softly and give us a little bit more of a natural look. And there's other settings we can do here to do bokeh, stuff like that. I've done individual tutorials on all of these tools. We could also increase it to high quality if we wanted. And then choose OK. All right, this is definitely better than the last time. We don't have those fuzzy edges anymore. The bottom is connected, it's looking better. However, notice as it gets closer to the camera, it's not really blurring. And also these trees are also just blurred, even though those are in a similar plane or a similar distance from the camera. So these should be a little bit sharper. But this is pretty good for an intermediate blur. All right. Okay, so I've got two more to show you. The next one's going to be very quick. I would also call this an intermediate, like maybe another option. But then the advanced option is going to get us a much better result, but we'll get to that in a moment. Okay, so for the next intermediate, we're going to choose filter. We're going to choose camera raw filter. Now, this is a newer feature, and you're probably familiar with it because I've done some tutorials on it before, so I'm not going to labor on this one really quickly. But if we go down, we can see lens blur. If I choose apply, so what it does is it uses AI image recognition to say, hey, this is the subject, and these areas should be further away, should be more blurred. So as you can see, we can adjust the blur amount. It's pretty good. One of the things you'll notice though, the masks are not great in here. See how that is missing some details here. The hair is a little choppy. But let's go down here. So under the focal range, we can also select this target and click on her face to make sure we're selecting her. Notice how things change just a little bit there. And we can also, with the focal range, we can change, you know, how shallow or deep we want the depth of field. We also have the ability to move this to change the focus. I'll link to another tutorial on this one because I think it's a useful tool. All right, I think we're getting a pretty good result there. All right, so why don't we go ahead now and we're going to do our advanced option. With the advanced option, what I want to do is I'm going to choose filter. And then I'm going to go down to the neural filters. So with the neural filters selected, we're going to choose depth blur. And I'm going to click OK. Now, we can adjust the amount of blur here. And notice it's using an AI to make the selection. We've got focus subject here, which it's selecting the subject. Of course, if we turn that off, we can click on here. And as we click on the thumbnail, it says, hey, this is the sharp part. And you can see this is a pretty good result. The edges are a little hairy, though. We've got some kind of realistic looking stuff going on here. It's missing some details here, but it's not bad. What it's doing is it's building a depth map. And that's actually what we're going to use. We're not going to be using this blur. Let's go down. And if you see the option here, it says output depth map only. This creates a depth map, meaning that as the areas are dark, they're going to be closer to the camera. As they're lighter, they're further away from the camera. It's kind of a similar thing you would use in 3D. So let's click OK. And by the way, Camera Raw also creates one of these, but it's not as easy to export it. So what we're going to do now is we want to just kind of clean up this depth map before we use it. So this is where we get complete control. So if I just hide that depth map layer for a moment, we can see, you know, there's some areas. Now it's up to you how far you want to go. So what I'm going to do is choose the background layer, make sure the background is on, and then we're going to use the select subject. Especially since the latest updates in Photoshop, the select subject is much more accurate than it is in the AI tool or in Camera Raw or Lightroom. All right, so we've got that selection. Let's go back into our depth map, and I'm selecting that layer. So now we're going to be working on this layer. And notice there's some areas that definitely we can fix. Let's zoom in a little bit. See these areas around here? Not as good. And notice the hair is not fantastic, but we're going to use this selection to help us. Notice it got a whole piece there that should have been out. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab the brush and we're going to paint directly on here. Usually I would paint on a new layer, but in this case, we're going to paint directly on it. Left bracket key will make the brush smaller, right bracket key will make it bigger. I want to sample this tone or this color, so I'm going to hold down the Alt or the Option key and then tap with the eyedropper. Sets the foreground color now to the same color, and I can go in here and paint over. Notice as I do that, I'm getting that nice detail there. Let's go around the hair, because I know that that's not going to be very good in the AI, but that's going to help us. Great. And you could actually go over all these edges if you wanted. Now, the next thing I want to do, though, is we've got this little gap here. I need to fix that. So we're going to hit Command-Shift-I, which is the same as choosing Select Inverse. We've selected everything but that. And now I want to select this color. So hold down the Alt or the Option key and tap. And when I say color, it's just a shade of gray. But we can go in here now and we can just, let's grab it here and we can clean that up a little bit. Control D will turn off the selection. Okay, so what we're starting to see now is our depth map is cleaner, it's better. But there's some other areas we need to fix. Notice at the bottom here, we got to be careful with this blending. Maybe we want this to blend a little better. So I'm going to make a large brush. Make sure it's a soft edge brush too. So you can see hardness is all the way down. Hold the Alt or the Option key in this area of gray and now we can paint. And notice what we're doing, we're just kind of blending that in. So that's going to be more just kind of blended in that area. Great. All right, so the next thing we could be doing is we could be working with some of these areas here. So let's have a look at that. So maybe I want to select these little branches. Now you can go as far as you want on this. I'm just going to do the branches, but understand you can really go granular with this. And if you're creating, you know, like a nice high resolution masterpiece, it's definitely worth the work. So the easiest way to select those is to grab the object selection tool. Make sure you change the mode from rectangle to lasso. So we just want to work on this one particular layer and let's make a little selection around there. And usually if you do these areas, you just do one at a time, you're going to get a better result. Holding down shift key, we're going to add to the selection. Let's go around here. All right, so we've got a good enough selection now. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back into this layer, make sure we're selecting that layer. And now we just want to paint on here. So we're going to grab the brush. Once again, hit the Alt or the Option key, select that tone. And then we can just paint. So remember, the darker areas are going to be more forward and the lighter areas are going to be further away. Notice this is a little bit lighter than her, which means that this is going to be further back, but not as far back as those other areas. If you wanted it to be on exactly the same focal plane as her, just hit the Alt or the Option key and sample the tone from the woman. And now you can paint on here and notice it's a little bit darker. And that's going to more closely match that focal plane of what she's on. Now remember, make it darker, it will come forward more. Make it lighter, it will go back. Control D will turn that off. And then it's just softly go around the edges just to create that nice soft blend. Perfect. Our depth map is complete. And now we are ready to apply it to our photo. I notice here is a little change. Let me just fix that up. Okay, so what we want to do now is we want to get that into a channel. So Control A will select everything. We want to copy it to the clipboard. Control or Command C. Great. Now let's go to the channels. And what we want to do now is we want to create a brand new channel and put this in there. So let's just create a new channel. It's called Alpha 1, which is an alpha channel, which is where you save selections. Let's paste into it since it's already selected. Control or Command V will paste and Control D will turn off the selection. And now we have a depth map in the alpha channel. We're seeing the depth map in all the channels because the other layer is turned on. So if we go back to the layers panel, click on the background and hide that. When we go into the channel C, now the channels just look normal. But there's our map right there, which is hidden. Perfect. We've done the difficult part. Now comes the fun and easy part, and that's to apply that blur. So we're going to choose filter, and then we're going to go down to blur, and then we're going to use lens blur. Now, lens blur gives the most accurate depiction of a lens blur inside of Photoshop. Okay, so notice right now the whole thing looks blurry. So let's go under the depth map. Under source, we're going to change that to alpha 1. Remember, alpha 1 is where we saved a depth map. Now it loads that depth map in and starts to understand the image. Okay, why is she still blurry? Because we haven't set the focal distance yet. If we move this focal distance, it's like we are focusing the camera in post. We could focus on the background. Notice how we're moving that. Now, if you want to put it on the person, choose set focal point. Click on her face. That's going to set that focal point to where our woman is. So if we look at this now, we can start to see, hey, this background there is starting to look quite realistic. There's our tree branches. Notice how these are popping now. That's the little bit that we missed. You know, we could fix that very easily in the mask. And then at this point, you're just going to choose, hey, how much blur do I want? Do I want to go really heavy or do I want to go a little bit lighter? Choose the amount of blur that you want. And then the last thing you probably want to do is change this from faster to more accurate. So if I'm in here and I see a problem, I don't have to apply it. I can just choose cancel, go back to the channel, and we can choose this alpha channel. And if you grab a brush, you know, we could fix this with a brush or make this selection. It's up to you, but I'm going to use a hard edge brush just to kind of show you how it works. I'm just going to take a brush here. Why don't we turn the other layers on so we can see that? There we go, and I'm just painting that little bit in there. Great. Hide that. You can see that's what I fixed. And then we just go back in, and we're just going to apply it again. Filter, blur, lens blur. And notice here, now that little gap is gone and it's fixed. So you can just go in and retouch your depth map at any time, which I'm very happy with the result right now. So we can just click OK to apply it. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Drop a comment underneath and let me know which technique you use and which technique you like the best. Maybe the perfect one is to blend them all or just use the right one for the right situation. And by the way, if you want to know more about the lens blur inside of Camera Raw and Lightroom, I have a tutorial on it right there. So if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials.